SportsCenter with Jay and Dan, presented by our friends at Tim Hortons. We're thrilled that you joined us, and we're going to get to the complete National Hockey League story in mere moments. Lots of Canadian teams to get to, but we have to start with that Monday Night Football game. That was just insane.
Yeah, the Monday Nighter, first it was supposed to be played in Mexico City. They moved it back to L.A. It's between two 9-1 teams. They gave away 77,000 tickets to this thing, to the first responders for the California fires and people affected. And guess what? It lived up to all of the hype that could possibly have gone with this game.
Especially if you took the over.
Yeah, the 64 total was the highest ever for a Monday Nighter. And they hit it, I'm not giving anything away, they hit it by the end of the third quarter. Patty Mahomes leads the NFL in passing touchdowns, down 13-0, could be a Super Bowl preview. Very next play, Mahomes, screen pass to Kareem Hunt. Great blocking, Hunt does the rest. 21 yards, gives Kansas City the lead. After a Rams punt, LA's defense looking to make their mark. Aaron Donald leads the league in sacks, forces the fumble, leading to a touchdown. Both quarterbacks coughing it up early before halftime. Chris Conley. What a catch! Mahomes' third touchdown of the half. It was 23-all at the break. Donald, the reigning defensive player of the year, forces another fumble in the third. L.A., they recover the ball in here somewhere. Led to a Goff rushing touchdown. Mexico City lost the game, but plenty of Rams fans still made the trip. Chiefs entered with only 8 turnovers in the first 10 games. Samson Ebuka gets his second defensive touchdown. That was such a weird play. 40-30 Rams through 3. Told you, they hit the over. Early fourth, Mahomes goes deep to Tyreek Hill. Wide open, 73-yard touchdown. Sam Shields slipped on the play. That's why he's so wide open. Brings the Chiefs within 3. Chiefs retake the lead. Mahomes going. Goff loses his second fumble. Incredible back and forth game 2 minutes later. Rams break the huddle quickly. Goff finds Gerald Everett. That's Goff's third passing touchdown. Rams are up 47-44. Mahomes with touchdown number 6 to Conley. Chiefs get to 51st. It's the most combined points in the history of Monday Night Football. Goff goes back to Everett down the sideline. And are you kidding me? L.A. takes the lead 54-51. Chiefs, one last chance. Mahomes, as he throws, he's hit, and it is picked off. Okay, with 25 seconds to go. Now, this is really a last chance for Mahomes. Again, looks deep, and it's a nearly identical play. As it's intercepted again. Game over. 54-51, the final. Goff. 4 touchdowns, 413 yards. Imagine being Mahomes. Throws for 478 yards, 6 touchdowns, which is the most ever in Monday Night Football, and loses. The 105 points were the most combined ever for a Monday Nighter. Most combined, if you're wondering, in an NFL game ever, 113 points. That was between Washington and the New York Giants in 1966. It was also the first game that both teams scored at least 50 points in NFL history.
And now to the NHL. The Leafs back home Monday after their California sweep to face the Metro-leading Columbus Blue Jackets, a showdown of two of the best goalies in the East as well. Freddie Anderson and Sergei Bobrovsky, a combined twin 0-1 in their last 11 games. Did I say twin?
When?
Jackets and Leafs. Cam Atkinson coming off a hat trick Saturday. Rene! Atkinson scores in a 5th straight game, 7 goals over those 5 games. Then it's Atkinson to emerging star Pierre-Luc Dubois. That's his 10th. He has a 5-game point streak. Columbus out shooting Toronto 14-6 in the period. They're up 2-0 as we head to the second. Tyler Ennis, looking like Sid Crosby behind the net, spins fire, scores. 3rd of the year, great individual effort. Buds are on the board. 5 to go in the period. Josh Anderson, breakaway. Fred Anderson, different spelling. Big save, still 2-1. John Tavares. 2 goals and 6 points at home. 10 goals, 17 on the road. Kasperi Kapanen long pass to Mitch Marner. Marner stop and then gets it to Tavares, who beats Sergei Bobrovsky for the goal. We're tied at twos after two third period. John Anderson gets another chance. Freddie Anderson, again, different spelling. Somehow manages to keep that out. Anderson trying to win a sixth straight start. Under 5 minutes to go, Zach Hyman wins the draw. Morgan Riley, friend of SportsCenter with Jane Dan, sends it toward the net. Hyman tips it in. Buds have a 3-2 lead. Torts very upset with Lucas Sedlak after the goal. And Hyman would add an empty netter as well. Leafs take it. They're rolling.
It was a one-anthem game in Vancouver. Jets and Canucks, all-Canadian battle. Vancouver's lost 5 straight. Just over a minute in, Patrick Laine leads a rush. Jacob Markstrom out to play the puck and just gives it right to Brian Little. Little's fourth of the season. 1-0, Peg City. Holla. Paul Maurice said high praise for his Pettersson pregame. Absolute missile by Patterson. It's 12th of the season. It's 1-1. Nick Ehlers starts a rush. Mark Scheifele driving the net.
Wheeler on the far side. Ehlers rips it.
And buries the rebound. Oh, it slipped out Markstrom's gear. He couldn't keep it contained. Jets power play. Scheifele to Kyle Getty. Oh, what? He roofed it, but did you see Scheifele's pass? He kicked it to him. 3-1 Jets after one. Second period. Pettersson runs into his own teammate, and Patty Laine scores his 9th of the season. Brutal turnover by the Canucks. Jets lean this one 4-3 in the third.
The return of Mike Hoffman to Ottawa. Not just the circumstances surrounding his trade from the team, but also the fact that Hoffman is thriving in his new home in Florida, a club record 15-game point streak. He was supposed to receive a video tribute during the third TV timeout of the opening period. But during the stoppage, a fan in the crowd suffered a cardiac arrest, an 83-year-old man who's unresponsive upon arrival to hospital, paramedics say. They decided to have the first intermission break early with 3.5 minutes still to go in the period. And when play resumed, Vincent Trocheck watched the right leg, a scary scene, obviously in a ton of pain, and obviously players on both teams clearly concerned. The game was delayed nearly 10 minutes before Trocheck was carted off on a stretcher, and Bob Bugner, the Panthers head coach, said he believes it's a serious long-term injury. In the second, Hoffman was given that video tribute, and he really did get a warm reception from the crowd in Ottawa. Spent the first 7 years of his NHL career in the nation's capital. Ottawa went into the third down 6-3, midway through the final frame. Bobby Ryan's pass off Zach Smith's chest and in, allowing us to use our popular SportsCenter with Jay and Dan catchphrase, that's using your chest. Less than 3 minutes later, James Reimer. Great effort to keep it out. Brady Tkachuk, fan favorite in the nation's capital. It's a one-goal game, but a familiar face would end Ottawa's comeback. TSN's Gord Miller on the call. Gord, a mentor to Dan and I and a good friend. Hoffman extends his league-leading point streak to 16 games.
Caps and Canadians, it was a great night of puck. Midway through the first, defenseman Mike Riley. Oh, what a move. Scores! He was a healthy scratch the last two games. His second of the season opens the scoring. Alex Ovechkin at the Bell Center Monday morning. Yeah, he can shoot. Ovechkin has 29 goals in 46 career games against Montreal. Just over 5 to play in the first. Tom Wilson to Ovechkin in front, beats Carey Price. Ovi's 14th of the season gives Washington the lead. Third period. It was a lot of Price versus Ovechkin. Let's start with the Caps on a power play. Ovechkin's 236 career power play marker ties the game at 4. That was Brian Mudrick on the call. Game still tied with under 9 minutes to play. Ovechkin. Robbed by Price! like a young Steve Penny. Ovechkin checking out that replay between the benches. 9 seconds, game still tied. Ovechkin and Price meet again. And Ovechkin applauds Price his effort. Ovechkin has 20 regular season goals against Price, no other players more. That play forced overtime in the extra frame. Lars Eller against his former team takes the pass, scores. Price allows 5 goals and 44 shots. Ovechkin 2 goals and 5 shots in the win. Price and Ovechkin's reaction to that late save.
Well, it's obviously, it's pretty cool, obviously. He's a great player, and he's had my number for a while, so it's nice to get him back once.
How I said, it was a pretty cool moment, pretty beautiful save. Fans was cheering for him. I was kind of same. You know,
that one was definitely up there. I think, you know, with the situation, with the time left, and you know, that's what he is. He's a difference maker, and you know, that's the level he's capable of pulling up stuff like that. That's you just gotta tip your hat.
As Dan mentioned, an incredible night of hockey on Monday. Golden Knights and Flames. Johnny Gaudreau, just 1 assist in his last 5 games. Early Flames power play, Gaudreau to a wide-open Tkachuk cheese. Matthew Tkachuk, 9 points in his last 9 games. 1-0 Calgary, then Flames on the rush, Gaudreau. We'll rip it past Malcolm Subban for his 7th of the year, doubling that Calgary lead. We're still in the first. Gaudreau will pick up the loose puck and tee up exciting, exhilarating Sean Monahan for his 11th of the year. Gaudreau stays onside just moments earlier. 3 first-period points for the first time in his career. Great start for Calgary. And we're still not out of the first, by the way. It is 4-0 Calgary. Gaudreau to Tkachuk, off the post. Monahan will clean it up. Calgary, 5 first-period goals at home for the first time since March of 1993. That's when Dan graduated from Peterborough High. But they weren't done there. Just 24 seconds into period two, Kachuk's wrister deflects past Subban. His 4th point of the night extends the lead to 6. Calgary rolling now.
Kings take it. And why are we showing you him? Well, I guess losing to the worst team in the league was the last straw for Blues GM Doug Armstrong, because immediately after that game, he fired head coach Mike Yeo and named associate coach Craig Berube as the interim head coach. Yeo becomes the 3rd coach fired so far this season, joining John Stevens and Joel Quenneville on the sidelines. Still to come, is the 3rd time the charm for the Stamps? Our CFL panel breaks down Calgary's Grey Cup problems ahead of this Sunday showdown next.
Now, before we check in on the new-look 76ers, I'd just like to take the opportunity to thank the other person on this show who, in my opinion, is the real star of the program.
Wow. Thanks. Didn't expect this, but just want to say that
Sarita Patel, our story editor, who recently returned to our show after a brief absence. No one, aside from me, of course, is as important to our success. Now, Joel Embiid facing DeAndre Ayton for the first time since tweeting, "Don't compare me to Ayton. I play defense," when Ayton was compared to Embiid during this year's NBA draft, and Ayton getting the better of Embiid here. The Suns rookie, nicely done. And then Embiid comes up with a huge block on Isaiah Cannon, showing another rookie how it's done. Dan is dying over here, literally. Oh, Embiid!
We're all dying slowly.
Yeah, I guess in a way, every human is dying. Anyway, Embiid dominating the 2nd half. Little inside move on Ayton. And then Embiid. Oh, that's nice. He had a team high 33. Ayton had 17, but the Sixers are now rolling. They won 3 straight, Hound Dog. They look good. Real good. Spirit Edmonton breakfast is going to be fun for Dan O'Toole on Saturday.
That's right.
Hopefully you make it till then and you don't die.
Thank you. I appreciate it. How are your pants?
They're so tight. What have I ate too much cheese before the show. Just a ton of cheese.
Too much cheese. The Jay on Wright story. The Yankees made the first big league move of the MLB season, acquiring Canadian pitcher James Paxton from Seattle. Now, the Mariners get three prospects in the deal, including top pitching prospect Justice Sheffield. Paxton, a 30-year-old Ladner, BC native. That's on the other side of the tunnel, for all of you familiar. He had, a no-hitter last year. He got attacked by a bald eagle.
Yeah, and he handled it really well.
Yeah. So that's huge for the Yankees.
Now, Kyle Lowry did not participate in Monday's practice after suffering a right ankle injury in Saturday's win against the Bulls. According to head coach Nick Nurse, the Raps point guard had the day off and is not expected to miss any time. As you can see, we wondered if he had died in the tunnel.
Oh. Yeah, he just kind of collapsed. Are you okay over there?
Yeah, I'm having problems with my mic pack, but I'm going to fix it right here. There we go, live TV, done. I just got to attach it to my belt and my tight pants. Good. The Stampeders and Red Blacks are set to square off in the 106th Grey Cup in the city of Champions. The Stamps looking to erase the memories the last 2 years when they lost the Grey Cup. Oh, Rodney!
I like watching the ice flow in the background. Mm. Big ice flow guy.
So when we come back on Ice Flow Truckers, the number one sports award segment among men aged 39 to 45, the Jannies. Next on Jay and Dan.
It's the Jannies. Good, bad, in between. Panthers, Sens. Juho Lamico scores one of seven Florida goals off a turnover. Check that was...
Malcolm Subban did not have his best game against Calgary, but makes a beautiful save here on the 2-on-0. Gets the pad down for your Las Vegas Golden Knights. Oh, it's a kick save. What a beauty.
Sabres and Pens. Phil Kessel takes the cross-crease pass. Stopped by Carter Hutton. Sabres, they win again.
See, the Jannies are the best and worst place. What do you think this one would be?
Ah!
Joel Embiid, 33 points, could have had 35.
Jackets and Leafs. Tyler Ennis picks up the puck near the faceoff dot, goes behind the net. He's back out, throws it on net. Scores? Did Bobrovsky not see this?
Looks like he's off the case. Spurs and Pellies, Frank Jackson. Action Jackson. Starring Carl Weathers and Vanity. I'm still surprised
every time. And this is just a great moment in NHL history. Ovi stopped by Carey Price, and then Ovi goes up and he applauds him.
And then they do the tap.
I mentioned this on yesterday's show, but it needs repeating. Have you seen this year's Grey Cup mascot? No? Okay, let me introduce you to Justin Bieber. He is 100% for real. I am serious. And another reminder that Canada is the best country ever.
What? Are you okay?
I had a sub before the show, and I had chocolate milk with it.
So a lot of cheese and submarines fueling us for this television.
Wow. That's maybe too convenient.
It is too convenient.
It is the Grey Cup. It is Sunday, and if you're making, you will be making Grey Cup chili, cumin. That's the ingredient you need. It sends it over the top.
This has been Cumin Center. Washington has signed free agent quarterback Mark Sanchez to back up Colt McCoy. McCoy, the new starter after Alex Smith broke his leg in Sunday's loss to the Texans. Sanchez will reunite with Redskins offensive coordinator Matt Kavanaugh, who is the Jets quarterbacks coach from 09 to 2012, Sanchez, 86 career TDs, and, of course, the butt fumble, which happened on November the 22nd of 2012, 6 years to the day Sanchez will make his Washington debut. Take a look at this. Ian Rappaport reporting on all the quarterbacks who got invited to try out for the spot. Antonio Cromartie responds, "I'm sorry, but none of these QBs are better than Cap. In fact, Mark Sanchez and Colin Kaepernick have something in common. Neither QB has played in the NFL since 2016.
Sanchez, he's already, though, his best season in the NFL 8 years ago.
Yeah, 2010.
Opening day of the 2019 Major League Baseball season is only 127 days away. Franchises, they're already gearing up for next year, which leads us to another installment of Spirits Close. Cleveland Indians unveiled their new collection of jerseys after the Chief Wahoo logo was officially retired. Club added a red home alternate and moved the navy blue jersey to a road uniform. Also, all ball caps going to don the Block C logo.
I like that. I like that cap.
And with Cleveland hosting the 2019 All-Star Game, the official All-Star logo will replace Chief Wahoo on the jersey sleeves.
And St. Louis bringing back their powder blues next season. They wore similar jerseys in 82. This time they have a St. Louis script and two Cardinals on the baseball bat. They'll wear their victory blue for Saturday road games. See, I don't get this. Why road games? Why not home games? They're beautiful, though. I love them. That was another stylish edition of producer Tim's favorite segment, Sports Club.
Still to come, darts and farts. A must-see post-match interview inspired our funny sound bites top 10.
I thought Wesley farted on stage. Did he?
No. Well, I think he thinks you did it.
You can put your finger up, there'll be no smell there. I thought he had and I went, that's dirty. It was bad.
It was bad?
It was bad.
He thought it was you.
Oh, no. Hands up. Swear on my kid's life. So help me God. Nothing crossed. Usually if I fart on stage, myself. If I'd farted it smelled like that, I'd put my hands up and go, oh, sorry. It was table side. It was eggs. Rotten eggs.
Not from you.
Not from me. And every time we walked past, it was a waft of rotten eggs. So that's why I was thinking of some.
We're talking dart fart.
We're talking dart fart.
And we've got more in the top 10.
And I appreciate my fans also. My wife and my girlfriend. I'm so sorry, my wife, Lizzo, I love you so much.
Renee Stubbs told me, she showed me a text message that you wrote to her about me in Sydney.
What did I say?
You thought I was pregnant?
Oh, she did not.
Let me say what was written in the message. First of all, it said she looks really grumpy and her boobs are bigger.
Oh my goodness.
Did you hear that?
All right, so we'll open it up to questions.
What do you plan to do after the All-Star game to get better?
Buy you a new jacket.
What's wrong with this one?
That's horrible. No, you know what that is? That's horror awful. That's horrible and awful mixed together. Horror awful.
Mike, were you really sick this week? What was the problem?
I broke my back.
What do you mean by that? You broke?
My back is broken.
What, a vertebrae or what portion?
Spinal.
What'd you say? Hey, who are you? What'd you say? Hey, get some. Get some. Get some. Keep running the hitches on your side. Just tackle. Just tackle. We don't know who you are. Keep walking. Keep walking. We don't know who you are. What's up?
How's your breath?
It's not good, eh?
No, I meant in terms of conditioning.
Oh. yeah, it's fine. I mean, obviously, it's a fast game out there, and, you know, you just catch your breath and go back after.
It's been fun watching it. Keep having fun, Phil.
Thanks, eh? I can't believe it.
In 2005, several Viking players were investigated following a bye week boat party. When asked about the incident, Moeldy Moore had this response.
No strippers, no sex.
No, none of that.
You know, sex, what are you talking about? Is that what, man, that's crazy. Sex, come on. Look, man, I'm engaged, so.
Yankees pitcher Chan Ho Park gave a very candid answer about why he didn't pitch well against the Angels.
I had a lot of diarrhea. That's what you want to know? Yeah, I had a lot of diarrhea. Yeah, I had a diarrhea and then. Why? Why is it funny?
It's my favorite. Never gets old.
No.
Hello, the night. Coming up. Very exciting edition of the J&M podcast. We just taped it on Monday, which we always do. It's brought to you by Coors Light. Craig Button, our NHL insider or analyst or whatever you want to call him, he joins us. And producer Tim calls in.
You don't want to miss that. Now it's time for the worst play of the day. Joel Embiid. I mean, he had 33 points. The Sixers beat the Suns, but that's embarrassing. Yeah, you're right, Ben Simmons.
A lot of choices for highlight of the night. This is the one we're going with, though. Star, respect star. Ovechkin robbed by Carey Price. And then comes over, shares a moment, applauds. And then low five.
I dig
pretty
it.
Cool.
We messed up a lot of stuff on this show. You said Carey Price faced 44 shots against the Caps. It was 34. Before the Leafs highlight, I said Freddie Anderson and Bobrovsky were a combined 20-0-1. 20 is not a number. I called the Vegas Golden Knights the Las Vegas Golden Knights. I still hate that. It's stupid. The name of the city is Las Vegas. It's stupid. Dan burped or coughed up something coming back from break after eating a Mr. Sub. I wasn't wearing makeup for the Dave Naylor interview. I don't know if you noticed, but it looked like I literally had just vomited.
Yeah.
And DJ Khaled and DMX do not make our music.
Oh.
It's all producer Tim on a tiny Casio keyboard.
Well, he's doing a pretty good job.
Not too bad.
Pretty good job. Zach.